Today we are going to start with our first experiment of concrete technology. So our first experiment is about slump coat test. What is the aim of our experiment? The aim of our experiment is to study the effect of water cement ratio on the workability of concrete by slump coat test. So what do you mean by workability? In other words, we can also say workability is the measure of amount of internal work which can be performed so that the concrete can be compacted fully. Or we can also say it is the ease with which we can mix, transport, compact and place the concrete on site. So this experiment is it can be performed on site as well as in the laboratory. So the apparatus consists of, this is the slump coat, this is the tapping rod, and this is a non-absorbent surface. So what does the slump coat consist of? It is a cone in the form of frustum of a cylinder. The top diameter is about 10 cm, bottom diameter is about 20 cm and the height is about 30 cm. And we have the tapping rod and non-absorbent surface. So what we are going to do is, we are going to take the different proportions of concrete. As we know, there are different mixes of concrete. From from M5 to M20, we can take any mix of concrete, because after that, from M25, we do a mix. What will it
be?
अरे सब लोग बोलो बोलिए शुरू से शुरू बोलो
आवाज़ बड़ा है
साथ में बोलो और सब की
ओके सो हियर वी आर गोइंग टू टेक प्रोपोर्शन ऑफ M50 व्हाट इज द प्रोपोर्शन ऑफ M50
1:4
सो हाउ आर यू गोइंग टू कैलकुलेट दैट हाउ मच सीमेंट यू गोइंग टू टेक हाउ मच फाइन एग्रीगेट हाउ मच कोर्स एग्रीगेट सो फर्स्ट यू आर गोइंग टू फाइंड आउट द वॉल्यूम ऑफ दिस कोर व्हाट इज द फॉर्मूला ऑफ द वॉल्यूम ऑफ कोर The formula for volume of coat is V is equal to pi H by 3. What is H? H is the height of this coat. Pi H by 3 in the bracket capital R square plus small r square plus small r into capital R. What is that small r is? The diameter of this upper, this 10 cm diameter. And capital R is this bigger diameter. So by that, what you are going to find out? Volume of what? Volume of cluster on this coat. So what is the formula for density? Density is mass of our volume. So how are you going to calculate the mass of the concrete? Density of concrete. What is the density of concrete? It is 2400 kg per meter cube. So first we will find out the volume of concrete from this formula. Pi h by 3 in the bracket capital R square plus small r square plus small r into capital R. After that, what we are going to do? What is the proportion of M50? 1:2:4. So, what is the total volume there? 2 + 1 + 4. That is 7. So, 1 means, first we will calculate cement. What will be the amount of cement? 1/7 into this volume. That will get the volume of mass of cement. How much kg we have to take? Then similarly for sand, coarse aggregates and fine aggregates, that will be 1:2:4 means 2/7 into volume and 4/7 into volume. Then we will get different proportions of that. What we are going to do, we will take we will be taking it on this and we will be mixing all the ingredients, and after that we will be trying it for different water cement ratio. First we will be trying for 0.4, then 0.5, then 0.6, and we will be seeing the quality of slump. How is the slump, the nature of the slump. Then first we will be taking 0.4. Then we will take water cement ratio, WyC is equal to 0.4. From that we calculate the amount of water to be calculated. W is equal to C into the water cement ratio. Then you mix the concrete and then what you do? You fill it in this slump coat. How will you fill? You will fill this in 3 layers. 3 layers, and after each layer what you will do? You will do tamping. The help of this tamping rod. How many rows you will give?
25.
You will give 25 rows after that. And then after the concrete is fully filled, you level it with the help of that trowel. You level it with that trowel, and then you will place this on a non-absorbent surface. And then after that, after leveling, then you will take it out. After taking it out, you will see the the slab. If it doesn't go down, if it is as it is, then it is called as true slab. If it falls down in inclination, in inclined manner, then it is called as shear slab. And if it collapses, then it is called as polar slab. So these are the three types of slabs. And then you will be measuring the value of how much centimeters it is gone down. From the top you will be measuring. See, this is the value of the slab. This is the height of the slab. This is the true height of the slab. And after taking it out, if it collapses down, then you are going to measure this height. So this is the slab value. So if it is in the range of, if it is in the range of 0 to 25, then it is very low slab. If it is in the range of 25 to 30, then it is low slab. If it is in the range of 25 to 50, it is low slab. If it is 50 to 75, then it is medium slab. If it is 75 to 150, then it is high slab. And above 150, it is very high slab. So as the slab value increases, the workability also increases. So this is the way in which you are going to perform the experiment. So please carry on. Start our core practical, that is the preparation of geological method. I already told you about the geological method, which was very simple, which has the original strata and plant strata. Now this is little bit complicated method. We are going to resolve the problem which is based on the fault method. I hope and everyone in this problem is fault. Or fracture is there, along which if there is some displacement is there, then we can say fault. Like you can see here, this is the excellent model of fault. Can you see some displacement over here? You can see this white line, and along this line, some displacement is there. See, as you all know, the faults are very dangerous for any large object because these are the plane where some displacement has occurred in the past, and we cannot deny such future displacement. Okay, such type of displacement. Very, very important to find out the faulting sites before any large construction. So in this geological map, we are going to prepare a large cross section of this map. And can you see some feature over here? See, this is lithology C. And this is again lithology C. Can you find out something along this line? Can you find out something along this line? What should be there? If this is C, C must be continuing. But can you see C, if this is C and again C is appearing over here?
Yeah,
if A is here, another A is here. B is here, another where is another B? B is here. So I can say along this line, something is happening. If I will color this map, then clearly I can find out this is the problem. Now how you will prepare this map? As you all know, these dotted lines are contour lines, and these solid lines are the ecological line. Everyone understand how we will calibrate the different stripe? We will join the points of equilibration, mark the stripe line, under stripe line, and higher to lower depth, and we will find out the angle. So, whatever the angle we will find, we will make an outline, then we will draw the angle. Now, after drawing this, you will mark this fault plane on your plan. Then clearly you can see the displacement. Now, if this is in one side, will you suggest this side for any construction? New side? Will you suggest any? No. Why? Because this may be a dangerous side. Okay, let's start.
This apparatus, we can calculate the optimum dosage of coagulant required. Optimum dosage means when we add some coagulant to any water, to make the coagulation or to increase the fastness of coagulation. Usually this coagulant will be alum. Alums are available in solid form or in powder form and in liquid form. So what we have to do is, so here there are six stirrers and we have to take the sample whose optimum dosage of coagulant is to be given. So these jars are 500 ml to 1000 mm. Say half liter to 1 liter. So as for the convenient, you have to take 6 glass and you have to fill with 1 liter and half liter of water. And previously calculated as a known value of coagulant, that has to be added in the middle of any one of these jars, middle. Usually middle one, you have to put the coagulant of known quantity, which is referred from the book or which is being calculated by trial and error. Then we have to add 2 ml more to the another container and another 2 ml to another container, and on the right side we have to increase 2 ml and in another last container another 2 ml we have to add. So here is the descending, here is the ascending. So this chiller is to be started and we have to give a 30 to 40 rpm speed for 5 minutes. Then afterwards 20 minutes lesser rpm than the 30, say 10 to 15 rpm, we have to stir it for 20 minutes. Then we have to allow this to settle. The main aim of this is by adding the coagulant there will be a formation of float. The float, what the float is going to do is it will catch the smaller particles which are not readily settleable in the water. So in this float, a smaller particle will start settling and increasing their sizes. Once the size gets increases, automatically the specific gravity of the particle will increase. And as we know, any particle whose specific gravity is more than 2.65 is readily settled. So likewise, flow formation, settling of this great particle into the flow and becoming a larger particle and settling. And then what we have to see is in which container more flow, more settleable suspension is there. For that particular container, how much coagulant we have added, that is going to be the optimum of coagulation. And that process can be used in for the larger scale of coagulation in the treatment tank. So this is what is about this issue. Follow my point?
Yes.
After that, we have to find the that is CD. CD is what? Actual discharge by theoretic. If you put theoretic, you will get the CD. It comes out, it will always comes less than 0.1. Okay? Repeat the procedure and take 3-4 videos and take the mean of that and you get CD.
So today we'll do the experiment number 5, that is the triaxial shear test of the soil. The main aim of the experiment is to determine the internal angle friction, that is phi, and the cohesion C of the given sample. In the last semester we have learned what is C and phi. Nitin, can you give me an explanation what is C? It is a cohesion property of soil. So the soils are divided as unconfined, confined in basis on the C and phi. So the procedure of this test, triaxial SCOE, that is undrained test, and the consolidation undrained test, that comes in the phase 1 of the experiment, and the phase 2 comes the drained test, which is known as the SCOE test. Can anybody tell me what is consolidation? Yes. Yes, removal of water by the application of load when it is reduced and the volume reduces in that case, that is consolidation. So the word comes the load when we apply load. So in this test, there is a load frame present over there and that time the load is applied on the mold, the water is expelled out and that time we get the value of C and phi in the reading. That's it. This is the load frame that we have spoken earlier. This is the triaxial cell which is connected to the hydraulic pump. Over there is a dial watch and which is connected to the hydraulic pump. And over there we put the water and it is at 10.45 Newton per meter square. The pressure is applied over here. And as it moves, you are seeing this is moving up and up. And anti-clockwise and clockwise. So it is moving in forward direction as well as in backward direction. So the readings are noted over here. This is the dial watch over here. And the amount of pressure that we are applying is noted over here. And see that in either cases, the sigma 1 and sigma 3. The sigma 1 is the major principal name and sigma 3 is a minimum minor principal strain. That is to be kept constant here over here. And that is the main function of this experiment, where we keep the principal plane to be constant. And here we can find the C and phi value.